Hello friends, today we will discuss about reproduction. Reproduction actually is the production of new individual from their parents. There are basically two types of reproductions, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. As you see, sexual reproduction is involved two parents or two different plants, and asexual reproduction is include new plants produced without any help of seeds. So friends, asexual reproduction does not involve fusion of male and female gametes. New plants may be developed from the vegetative parts. Vegetative reproduction basically is two types, that is natural vegetative reproduction and artificial vegetative reproduction. Natural vegetative reproduction include rhizomes, turmeric, tuber, potato, corn, arby, bulb. And artificial vegetative reproduction involve two parts, stem cutting, sugarcane, basically called ganna, grapes, rose, and root cutting, sweet potato and citrus. So we will discuss about the sexual reproductions. Sexual reproductions are reproduction in which seeds are take place in reproduction. Flowers are the reproductive parts of the plant. Stamen is the male reproductive part and pistil is the female reproductive part. Flower which have only one stamen is called unisexual flower, and the example is maize, papaya, cucumber. Flowers which have both stamen and pistils, means which have both male and female parts, that is called bisexual flower, rose, mustard, petunia. The stamen has a filament and anther. The anther contain pollen grains which contain the male gametes. The pistil has stigma, style, ovary, and ovary contain ovules. In sexual reproduction, the male and female gametes fuse together to form a zygote. Types of asexual reproduction. First of all, we will study about asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction in animals is found in the form of budding, like hydra, regeneration, fragmentation, fission, binary fission, and in plants, that is budding, tubers, runners, and bulbs. Types of asexual reproduction: binary fission, fragmentation, vegetative propagation, budding, parthenogenesis. So these are different animals where it is found. This is some example of animals. Now come to the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproductions is vegetative propagation, binary fission, budding, and sporogenesis. This is the picture of hydra, and you can see here is a budding growing. You can see it is here. This is the. Now come to the next, that is spore formation. Spore formation happening in fungi, green algae, molds, and non-flowering plants. Spores are produced and each spore develop into offspring which are identical to their parent. These are the two examples, fungi and fern. Now come to the fragmentation. Fragmentation is the form of asexual reproduction where a new organism grow from the fragments of parents, and each fragments develop into a mature, fully grown individual. The both of the parents break into some pieces and then each pieces develop into a whole animals. Most of lichens which are symbiotic union of fungus and alga or bacteria reproduce through the fragmentation to ensure that new individual contain both symbiotes. Actually The lichens is the best example of symbiotic union. Planaria is the example of fragmentation. You can see the picture of planaria here. This is the picture of planaria. Now come to the vegetative reproduction. Vegetative reproduction, actually the form of asexual reproduction in the plants, where parts of the plants fall off and develop into new plants without seeds or spores. Examples: potatoes, potatoes tubers, tulips, strawberry, blackberries. You can see here is, this is the blackberries, this is strawberries, and this is tubers. How do plants reproduce asexually? So here the key concepts are: plant reproduce asexually through vegetative propagation, as we discussed in the previous slide. That is natural reproduction and artificial reproduction. Natural reproduction include bulbs like onion bulbs, tubers, potato tubers, runners and rhizobiums. You can see the runners of wild strawberries, and yes, this is the picture of wild strawberry and the best example of runner. Now come to the rhizobium. Rhizobium is the best example of haldi or turmeric, which we use in our kitchen. Now come to the artificial propagation, that is cutting, layering and grafting. We will discuss in the, this is the picture of bryophyllum. So this is the picture of bryophyllum, which is commonly called ajuba plant, this one. Now there I have two pictures. You can see on your screen, that is artificial vegetative propagation. The picture one is showing cutting and the second one is showing grafting. So as you see here, the branch of plant is cutting. Branch of plant is cutting and it is planted in the different pot. In the second picture you can see here, this is the grafting. So in the grafting, small root system is taken and it is grafted here. You can check, this is the season and this is the stalk, and now the new plants is to the next slide. You can see here the mating is happening, egg nucleus, and these are the pollen nuclei, and now they are mating and they form the zygote, and the after that zygote convert into the seeds. This is the part of seeds which is so embryo seed coat, and after that it's become a seedling. So now come to the oogenesis. Oogenesis actually occurs in the ovaries, resulting the reproduction production of one egg and three polar bodies. Begin with the female is an embryo. Oocytes form before birth and remain frozen in the stage of indefinitely. So we can say when a female child is born, their ovaries already have some frozen eggs. So this is called oogenesis, but they are in the dormant condition. And now this is the spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis occurs in the testes in the seminiferous tubules, result in the production of four sperms, mature in the epididymis and gain motility, produce constantly after puberty. Now come to the gamete transfer. In majority organism, male gametes is motile, where as female is stationary. Exception in few fungi and algae, both types of gametes are motile. So this is the exceptional case. So this is the exceptional case. A new fungi and algae, both types of gametes are motile. A medium is required through which the male gametes move. In algae, bryophytes and pteridophytes, water is the medium for gametes transfer. To compensate loss of male gametes during transport, the number of male gametes produced and several thousand times the number of female gametes produced. So finally we come to the fertilization. What is the fertilization? Fertilization means fusion of male and female gametes is called fertilization, and it's occur inside the ovule. Fertilization is basically two types. It is external fertilization and internal fertilization. As you see in your screen, we will discuss about external fertilization. You can compare both two pictures. In external fertilization, eggs laid by the female are fertilized by sperm of male in the external environment, and the best example is frog and fishes. You can see the male fish wait to spread sperms over the eggs, and this is the female fish lays the eggs. Now come to the internal fertilization. In internal fertilization, the fertilization takes place inside the female body, moist reproductive tract. So the best example of internal fertilization is birds, reptiles and mammals. Small number of eggs and greater chance to survival. So we can